My name is Robert Herman. I'm a photographer who's been in New York since 1976, and I'm working on a street photography book entitled The New Yorkers, and I'm here on Kickstarter to show you some of the images and ask you to help us. Most of the time I was completely invisible. They weren't aware of me at all. When I started shooting, I was just, you know, dressed in pretty innocuous clothing, just trying to blend in, and just trying to make as authentic pictures as I can. I started shooting street photography when I was a film student at NYU, and I just found that I was really good at this, and I was kind of surprised. To me, it was very important to be a witness, to just be a bystander like a journalist would, not influence the action except by choosing the framing and the time of day and the light and the composition and letting things happen. It was a really dangerous neighborhood. There were hookers everywhere. There was a lot of mugging. Scorsese had shot Taxi Driver a couple of years beforehand on the corner. And I was like 21 years old. So it was a different place, and there was graffiti everywhere. People were so much less self-conscious about images. It hadn't become a media culture yet. And Samo really is dead. Things will never be the same in New York. So I walked outside, walked around the corner, and there were those two cars parked at an angle into the sidewalk. And the little kids walked by, and I shot a couple of frames. This is where the Spring Street Natural restaurant is now, but 25 years ago, it was kind of a divey little coffee shop, and it was kind of mysterious, and a lot of local guys hung out in there. What you see is a storefront mannequin looking from the window out into the street. And there's a really nice shadow of the window falling on the ground in front of the mannequin. And it looked like a nice composition. And then a moment later, this guy runs in and jumps up on this wall. And that's when I snapped the picture. This is a picture that I took on the R train in Long Island City in 1985. It's one of my favorite images because it was one that I didn't realize that I had for a long time, and when I went through my pictures, I found it and I was like, huh. Why am I on Kickstarter? I'm on Kickstarter to take this book called The New Yorkers to the next level. Based on the feedback that I've gotten from publishers, that they really like the content of the book. But I need to get high resolution drum scans of all the images in the book. I need to hire a writer to write something interesting, memorable, and insightful about the images and help a larger audience understand and appreciate why they're interesting. And thirdly, I needed to hire a graphic designer who will bring the images together in a way that will be really appealing to a general audience. I'm asking for $7,500. Hopefully we'll get more. Because making a photo book is really expensive. And I need your help to turn these images into a book that's gonna get published. And for $125 or more, I'd be glad to send you a signed copy of the published book. when you make a frame around something you've seen in the street, it becomes a metaphor for taking the mundane and turning it into something that possibly could be transcendent. And I like that.